It was a cool, moist start to summer. Spot the heron on the post. There was a strong wind from west-northwest. A sequence of views across the vale, from northwest to northeast. Thank you. almost ready to harvest. A useful place to sit. Back to Whitehorse Car Park. They've repaired the bridge across the brook, but fenced off a dead tree. We had a moist start to July. This is how they manage the grass. This is a maintenance job on the bridge with reduced capacity. Quiet this evening though. Passing through Dunampany, over the last decade, lots of new vineyards have sprouted up in southern England. This is the vineyard entrance. According to their site, they also farm sheep, which graze around the vines and fertilise them. The hut is a cellar door shop. Half a dozen bottles have been bought today. On the climb to Armistead Junction, there was a fleet of buses, many battery electric ones, from Newport used to replace trains on account of the Severn Tunnel closure this weekend. For these images, the settings were adjusted to emulate the colour balance of the old Kodachrome film, which I used a lot in the past. This camera has a range of preset options and a custom one, with the figures used shown here. The net effect is that the red end of the scale is emphasised a bit, with blue and green being tweaked down. This is a continuation of the Kodachrome emulation, albeit on a cloudy day. Thank you. And here's another option, emulation of Fuji Pro. It has reduced contrast with red and blue toned down. There was a lot of rain yesterday and earlier today. There were 7 cygnets this year. It would be muddy that way, so round the lake is better. That's the Aris Cross, less efficient than the others. So at the end of the day, red and green are toned down a little, with green being neutral, and minimum contrast and maximum sharpness. These clips were done ISO 400. The next few minutes were shot on an iPhone, limited manual control, just a choice of focal length and a few steps. The ray again. A disused gate. Everyone uses this route. The ray again, as it passes under the canal aquifer. South along the canal towpath. Crossing the ray again on the footbridge into Purton. Another disused gate. Bremel Fuel Depot. It's part of the pipeline network now, but years ago there used to be a connection to the Kemble line. The footpath passes under the Kemble line. On the west side, there is a relatively new housing estate in Purton. Straight on is the old Purton Road. Now it goes through the estate, with houses actually on the distribution road. Back along the old Purton Road. The modern Purton Road over the canal. This Thames Water job is almost done. And back on the old Purton Road. On a cloudy, showery afternoon, using the Canon G15 again, with the same custom setup as last time. I've tried a few different colour balance setups on the G15, while there aren't any on the HTC 300 or the iPhone. They do their own thing.